What is going on, guys? Welcome back to my channel. This is Darian with Darian the Dev, and in this video we're going to be talking about whether or not you should work while you're in coding bootcamp. So this video is actually coming from a question I got from another viewer on a different video asking what I thought or what my thoughts were on him working during coding bootcamp. Before we get into answering this one, please make sure you like, share, and subscribe. We're always dropping motivational, cultivational content for new developers and entrepreneurs on this channel. This one, I have a pretty straightforward answer on this one, and it's no. I do not think that you should work while you're in coding bootcamp for a number of reasons. So the first reason is that coding bootcamp doesn't end in the classroom. So yes, you're gonna be spending a lot of time and a lot of weeks in that classroom, but there's gonna be things you have to do outside the classroom in order to graduate still. So one is like applying for jobs, which, as I'm sure everybody who watching this video knows, that applying for jobs sometimes can be a full-time job. So that's gonna take a lot of time. To give you an example, starting in the fifth week of my bootcamp, we had to apply for 10 jobs a week, I believe. So 10 jobs a week, after coding bootcamp from 9 to 5 every week, you know what I mean? You can kind of like imagine how much time that might take out of your week. So that's one thing. There's other things besides just being in class that you have to do in order to graduate. Work is going to extend out of the classroom. So that would be my number two thing, is that there's always going to be labs or homework or assignments, whatever they call them at your coding bootcamp. You're going to have things that you need to take home and complete. And those are going to help reiterate the lesson you learned that day in class. Is going to help you to practice, get better. So you're going to have to dedicate some time to that. If you're going to work, if you're going to coding bootcamp from 9 to 5 and then you're getting off and going to work at 5:30 or 6 o'clock, you're going to be burnt out like so quickly. I mean, again, you're stepping into a new world. So whatever industry you're working in, or wherever, you know, you've been working for the past 10, 15, 20 years, whatever, tech and development is going to be a whole different world. And I think that at some point you have to start making that transition out of one and into the other. So if you're trying to do both, it kind of prevents you from fully committing to the change in mindset and the shift that you need to really become, to really get the most out of your bootcamp experience. I think you kind of have to really just dive all the way in and just immerse yourself, because again, it's only going to be like a 2.5 to maybe 6 month program depending on what boot camp you go to. But in that 2.5 to 6 months, you're getting between 2.5 and 3 years of actual coding experience. So when you put that together, that's a lot of work being done in a small period of time, and it's all new stuff. So if you don't have like a prior reference in your mind, it's going to make it even kind of harder to grasp new, you know, concepts that you've never heard of before. So I would definitely recommend, kind of as much as possible, eliminating or limiting the amount of hours you work. I totally get it. You're an adult. We're all adults, so you have bills to pay. So I get that. Fortunately, I received a scholarship during my boot camp, so I had some money set to the side that I could use to kind of keep me afloat and just only focus on coding while I was in coding boot camp. But you know, if you guys don't have that luxury, I would highly suggest maybe saving up money so that you can cover all your living expenses while you're in coding bootcamp and then quit your job, or only work on the weekends, which is what the classmates I had who did work, most of them worked on the weekends, not during the week. So if you really have to make it happen, guys, that would be my suggestion, is only work on the weekends. That's like the only scenario I see really working out and making sense. But yeah, so, you know, those are just a few of my tips, guys, on like, should you be working while you're in coding bootcamp? And it's a very great question, a very valid question. So I'm glad that someone had asked that on a previous video. For anybody else who's considering, just again, I would make a list of maybe pros and cons of each. So pros and cons of going to coding bootcamp, and then pros and cons of staying at your current job, and see which one makes the most sense when you finish that list. I know it's kind of not super helpful, guys, but I'm not in your position, so I can't really tell you what to do. And I have a biased opinion being a bootcamp graduate, so that didn't work while I was in coding bootcamp. So I kind of have a biased perspective on it. So I'm just giving you what I think are the best, most helpful tips for success while you're in coding bootcamp. And I think if you're working, you're gonna miss more hours of sleep at night, which is gonna make it harder to wake up in the morning and go to coding boot camp, which is gonna make it harder to pay attention, which is gonna make it harder to retain information, which is gonna make it harder to learn, which is gonna make it harder to pass tests. Like, it's just a snowball effect, guys. Every day during coding boot camp, my coding boot camp was from 9 to 5. During that time, I was going to bed before 10 p.m. every single day. So, you know, I'm up at like 7:30 in the morning, but I'm going to bed by like before 10 p.m. at night. So that 9 to 5, I'm locked in, I'm well rested, ready to learn, and I think it really helped me a lot. So I would just highly recommend considering that. So yeah, guys, that's all I've got. Make sure before you go, check out the description box down below. I've got a free coding bootcamp success checklist. So if you guys are confused or not sure about if coding's for you or if coding bootcamp is for you, if you can check off everything on this checklist, then you guys are definitely ready to apply for bootcamp and get started and be successful. So that's down in the description below. Also, I have a free front-end resource guide for any new front-end developers or just developers in general who just want to take a look at a cheat sheet. I've got that down below for free in the description box. Check that out, guys. Make sure you like, share, and subscribe one more time. I really appreciate it. This is Darian with Darian the Dev, and I'll see you guys in the next video, all right? Peace.